right around the corner, and who better to give us travel tips than the woman who helped the president travel? Here for today's Windy City 101, please welcome back Laura Schwartz.
Laura! Thank you!
You travel, like, how many days out of the year?
About 70% of the year. Sure. I travel, and about 50% of that's abroad.
Yeah, so, and you're on your way to a flight today.
I am. I fly out to London, on to Finland, and I'm back on April Fool's Day.
Wow. Oh my God. And you say you love it? See, traveling, I hate traveling.
I do. It's a passion of mine. I love the adventure with it. I travel for business, and I speak around the world, but then I always add in some great, fun things to do. My hosts always take me around. It's a great experience. I take my parents everywhere around the world.
Oh,
they are the best travel partners ever, and
so
we have a blast.
Now, see, I love when I get there, but it's like the actual getting on the plane and going through all of that stuff that's a pain, but you're going to help us, give us some tips,
and
we're
going
to make things easier.
Yeah, some stuff that we probably don't think about that, you know what, we should, especially in this day and age, and we'll start with travel warnings. You know, the moment I get asked to give a speech, whether it's Bogota, Colombia coming up, or Helsinki, or Dubai, or even within the United States, but this is especially for abroad, go to state.gov. That's our State Department website.
Okay.
And you just look up travel warning and the country you're going to, and in fact, the city that you're going to.
Oh.
And it's going to bring up a whole page about that city, about that country. It'll tell you what active travel warnings are going on, such as if they advise Americans not to travel there, or if, for example, in a country I'm visiting soon, they advise Americans that kidnapping was more prevalent in 2001 and has subsided, but you stay away from rural areas. So they give you really good tips. They'll also tell you what scams are going on in country. Are people walking up to you asking for change because their parking meter's overdone? Or do they have some sort of set story? Or in some areas of Africa, you don't want to keep your wallet in your back pocket or in your backpack. I don't think you ever should. But they will come up and knife your pack and just get your stuff out.
Mm.
But they know what trends are happening. And with this information, we can be vigilant and have a very safe journey. So always check the travel warnings. State.gov. Also there, you're going to get the number for the U.S. Embassy. Always take that with you.
Okay.
Always take that with you.
What's the next step program?
Well, that's also at state.gov as well. It's for secure travelers. So what you do, it's STEP, S-T-E-P. You're going to have the website on your website.
Sure.
So you want to enroll in STEP before you go abroad. You go onto the website. You create a user ID and password.
Okay.
Your information is safe. It's not shared for any other reason except you put in your password. Information, you put in your information, where you're going to be staying and the address of the hotel, a contact for while you're away, and if you have multiple stops, you do all the multiple stops. This is so that the State Department knows where you are in case of emergency.
Oh.
If there is a tsunami, if there is a terrorist attack of some sort, if there is an impending threat, they can find you and get you out. Or your family can call the State Department if they're concerned and they can help find you. So it's very important you roll in step.
All right, we don't want to run out of time here.
Yeah.
Now, also take us through the products that you should have with
you.
Okay,
now this is awesome. Pressure socks are not just for your grandma anymore. Pressure socks, you know, they're brown, they're kind of ugly, they don't feel very comfortable, but I tell you what, with deep vein thrombosis, with long flights, you want to wear pressure socks, but you don't want to just go to buy like a cheap pair of socks. Go to your pharmacy and get fitted for them because they have to be a good bit of pressure, but not too much pressure because the objective here is to keep that blood flowing back up to your heart, but you don't want it to be cutting off your circulation.
Exactly.
So get fitted at a pharmacy and you can even go local and get really fun colors. This is Fleet Feet over on Wells.
Oh,
and they measure you there too. So you're not just buying it off the rack. So I encourage you to do that.
Okay.
Wear those on the flight. The other thing, pack in your suitcase, a pillowcase. This is a pillowcase cover.
Okay.
It resists bed bugs.
Oh.
Okay. So what I do is I get to the hotel, I take off their pillowcase, I put this on, and then I put their pillowcase back over so it's nice and silky, right?
You're right, because I never thought
about
that.
But do that, and before I do that, the first thing I do when I walk into a room, no matter if it's a one-star or a five-star hotel, I take my flashlight. And I peel back the sheets, I peel back the mattress cover, and I shine a light right underneath all of the lip of the mattress itself. If there are bed bugs present in your hotel room, most likely they're going to be hiding under there. Another thing you can do is flip open your laptop, set it up on the bed, go walk out for a while, come back. The heat from the laptop simulates a body, and so if you come back and there's bugs there, get out
of there
fast.
But you will be able to see these bed bugs.
You do see the bed
bugs. They're not so minute where you can't see them.
But you know what? Look for them. Otherwise, you're going to miss them. And also, like, in the corners of the ceiling, you'll see if they're up there.
But you have the Lysol can.
Yeah,
I just spray everything.
And
yeah,
why
I do
that? To keep it clean. You know, just like on, first off, on the airplane, I carry the Lysol wipes.
Yeah.
Because, man, there's strep, there's influenza A and B, there's fecal matter.
Now, Laura, do you like to put everything in Ziploc bags? Because even the Lysol can is in a Ziploc bag.
Because that goes back to bed. I know, that's just convenience, and I'm a little anal about that. But for bed bugs, I pack everything in my suitcase in Ziploc bags, the clothes, the everything. Because God forbid you get bed bugs in the stowage area of a plane compartment. If they try to go through your zippers, they're still going to be, you know, fought back by
the plastic. Plus, another thought, if something spills, heaven forbid this cap comes off or anything, you don't want it spilling on your clothes.
I do the big Lysol in my suitcase. I spray down the room after I check for bed bugs. And then every day after the maid's been there, I spray my remote once more. I spray down the touch surfaces because, you know, they're servicing other rooms really well. Then they touch your room. So.
All right. Last thing, the photocopies of your passport.
Keep a Xerox in each one of your bags. And then when you arrive at your location, put your actual passport in the safe to keep it safe. And then carry this with you when you're outside. If you lose your passport at some point, you're going to have those Xerox in your suitcase to take to the embassy and get a new one printed faster.
Good tip.
Have a safe flight, Laura. Now that we have all of this great travel info, and since our friends over at Southwest Airlines are celebrating their 30th anniversary today, they're feeling quite generous. So one lucky audience member is about to win two round-trip tickets to wherever Southwest flies in the U.S. So get your numbers out, everyone. Laura, will you please do us the honor?
This is, such pressure. Oh, this is a good number. 22.
There you go.